At the University of South Florida, we are urging everyone to get a vaccine. We are making them easy to get through student health, through USF health. We're also reminding everyone that we expect everyone to wear a face mask because the virus is active in our community, quite active right now. And we want to do everything we can to prevent transmission of the virus. We want to do everything we can to keep our campus open, all of our activities moving forward, so that people can do the things they came here to enjoy. So please get a vaccine. Please wear a face mask. Please help us keep our community safe. People have been working on both coronavirus vaccines for many, many years and mRNA technology for vaccines for many, many years. And what changed was now we have a world pandemic. Everyone came together, laboratories, companies across the globe. They worked together, they shared information, and resources were plowed into the creation of a vaccine. So I'm very, very confident that we had the best minds working together across the globe with the resources that they needed to actually perfect an mRNA vaccine for coronavirus. The trials that went on for this vaccine are the exact same trials for any vaccine. The only difference here is that in between each segment of the trial, the time was shortened. But we went through all phases, all three phases of the clinical trials for the vaccines. And because we had so many people working on this together, hundreds of thousands of people were enrolled in these clinical trials. So this may be the most well-developed, well-studied vaccine that has ever been produced. So it's totally understandable that people will be concerned about fertility or effects on a child. It turns out there were a number of people enrolled in the original clinical trials who became pregnant during the trials. And that was good in that we now know that there was no effect on fertility. There was no effect on the outcome of the pregnancy. So that was just a happy occurrence that happened. And they are continuing to study, as I said, in all populations, including women of reproductive age, including those who become pregnant during the trials. This variant turns out to be very easily transmitted, and some people who have gotten the vaccine are getting the variant. I think it's very important for people to understand that they have only mild symptoms. So the vaccine absolutely prevents against severe illness, hospitalization, and death. We do know they can transmit the infection, but it turns out they are only infectious for a day or two, whereas unvaccinated people who get this particular strain of the virus are infectious for a longer period of time. Even people with the vaccine can become infected and can transmit. Again, less likely to be infected, less likely to transmit, but the fact that it can happen at all at a period when the virus is running rampant through the unvaccinated population, anything we can do to prevent that spread is positive. So that's why the CDC changed their guidance and said everyone needs to wear face coverings when indoors and certainly when in crowded spaces outdoors. It's better to create herd immunity through a vaccine, one, because we don't want people to be infected if we can help that, so that's one. But also, if you do become ill from an infection from COVID-19, you're likely ill due to one particular strain. The vaccine protects against all strains so far. That seems to be the case. And if you are infected by a strain of the virus, you may get a weakened dose, you may have a weakened response. The vaccine assures that your body develops immunity in a more powerful way than if you just have a small dose and a weak response. That doesn't necessarily protect you long term like the vaccine will. The unknown fear about what might happen with a vaccine has to be countered with the known reality of what can happen if you get COVID. Right now, there are no known effects of the vaccine. We do know what the risk is of COVID. So people's concerns about that, though I understand where they come from, you would hate to be in a situation where you're saying, I wish I got a vaccine, when you could get one now. You could get one now and hopefully prevent severe illness in yourself, in a family member, in someone you love, someone that you care about. And I like to say to people, you never know when you may save a life. So please get a vaccine. Please wear a face mask. Please help us keep our community safe.